Hi guys, I'm Tung at TeamPress, the team that creates the best-selling education WordPress team and also LearnPress, the most powerful LMS on WordPress. The purpose of this video today is to give you guys a tutorial and review of the team, the Eduma or Education WordPress, an Education WordPress team by TeamPress. Currently, it's the best-selling education team on TeamForest. The best thing about the team is that it comes pre-packaged with a lot of additional premium plugins. For example, it comes with all the add-ons for LearnPress, which may cost you $290 if you buy some other teams. Secondly, all the designs and all the elements of the teams are already built, so it wouldn't take too much of your time to set up your education website. All you need to do is to follow the instruction, and everything will be automatically installed, up and running in just a few clicks. So if you are on this page, or you can go to TeamForest, look for Education WP over there, or you can click into the link in the description of this video. You will see a bunch of different layouts and demos pre-decorated for you. You just need to import the layout that you want to use to your WordPress website. One click install and a few customizations and it will be done. So I suppose that you already have WordPress, or you know how to install WordPress on your website. If you don't know how, check out the description. I will send you a link on how to install WordPress and the introduction to WordPress. Okay, so here I have a fresh install of WordPress on my own server, which is a brand new installation. There isn't anything here, and I'll show you how to install the theme, import demo data, and do some customizing. First, you will need to install the theme. If you haven't had it, check out the link in the description. Go to your website /wp-admin, type your username and password to your login to the administration, the backend of the website. Go to appearance, theme. Click on add new, upload theme, choose the file, the zip packet. Okay, now you will need to activate the theme. Now if you look at the main page, although we have installed the theme, there is still nothing because the configuration of the theme isn't finished yet. Now we need to config all. Switch to the administration tab. You will see a prompt that asks you to install and activate all the relevant plugins. Also, you will see a prompt that say demo importer is ready to use. It is where you need to go to. Remember, if this is your first time using WordPress, or even if you have already used WordPress several times before, but this is the first time you use this theme, remember to read all the notice and information before doing anything, because it is a complex system. And if you did something wrong for some sections, it will be quite difficult to make things right. Of course, there will be sections that can be fixed easily, but there are sections that cannot be fixed easily. So click on the demo importer. You will see a lot of demo layouts, design which fits you and your organization the most. And click on import. It may take several minutes. Enjoy a cup of coffee in the meantime. By the way, if you have any problem with the team, there is an active supporting forum for the team here at teampress.com/forums. Okay, installation is done. Now you can go to the homepage and see the result. It looks a whole lot different from the last time we checked, right? But there's still some areas of the web that isn't displaying properly. And let's see what we can do. Change this black thumbnails to make the sign looks better. Click on it. It is the thumbnail of this page, so choose edit. You will be redirected to the setting page for this course. Click on Set Features Image. Choose the image. And after that, the course will have a new thumbnail image. It is the same with everything else. How about this? It's a bit different from the course item because there isn't a button to click on. So you will see it is the testimonial section. So you just go to the testimonial on WP Admin, click on the item, choose the image that you want. After changing the image, your site will be way better than before. One another thing you need to config is the footer menu. As you can see here, there's a lot of spaces that we don't need. The footer isn't optimized while it should be. Go to widget, choose the footer, page builder, click on every section, select the corresponding menu with the title. Done, that's it. Okay, so how to edit mega menu? It's already in the documentation. You can find here docs.teampress.com/edumer. Step 1, install and activate plugin WhoSidebar. Go to the plugin page, add news. Install and active plugins, and then you will need to create sidebars for mega menu. Go to appearance, widgets, areas, add news, and config as I do here. And click update to get the changes. Step 3, add widgets into the created sidebar. Step 4 is configure menu. So it's done. So next time you want to edit the mega menu, you know where to look for. Then we will move on to the menu. Look at the menu. It may look okay, but when hovering in, you will see that some links may lead to the default menu. I go to appearance, menus. Edit the custom link with your own link. What's next? The contact form. In Education WP, there are two form systems. One is the contact form that allows users to send email to the administrator, and the other is the integrated system with MailChimp, so that you can send newsletter and promotion to your subscribers. Look at a contact form here, edit page. This said that the contact form ID is 4. Go to contact, contact forms. There is a form with ID 4. Go to mail, This is the default email for the team. Change it with your email so that your users can send emails to you. Otherwise, it will go to the inbox of that email. And now we will config MailChimp. Look at this contact page. You will see this section doesn't show anything. Actually, it says there is an error. Click on Edit Page. There is a shortcode for MailChimp, but since there isn't any ID here, it doesn't display anything, just like what the error said. Now you need to go to MailChimp, copy the shortcode, put it back to where it should be. And save, and it will be done. Just configuring these parts, your website will be done and will be able to use very well in real life. If you install an all of WordPress add-ons, your website will be even better. If you have any problems, just comment below and I will try to explain to you as detailed as possible. One more thing, if you want to receive weekly tips and tricks about how to manage an education website efficiently in all aspects, you should subscribe to our mailing list below. Thank you and see you next time in our next videos. Bye bye.